What we're learning about today is the Spike Prime's force sensor. The force sensor is a physical input sensor that you can program to detect when you give it a single tap, a quick tap, or a press and a hold. But what really makes this sensor great is that it can detect the amount of force that's being applied in newtons. The maximum force it can detect is 10 newtons and the minimum is 0. And newtons are a force of measure that might not be very intuitive right now, but you can still program and use this sensor even if the units are a little bit unusual. What we're going to do with the sensor today is create a simple proportional controller that will control the speed of a motor depending on how hard we press the sensor. We're going to be coding in both blocks and Python. And as always, you can jump to the section you need using the timestamps in the description below. Let's go ahead and get started. Make sure that you have a program opened up in blocks, and at the very top you can see that the Spike's force sensor icon is right by the hub icon. So what we're trying to make is a proportional controller, so when we apply more force to the sensor, a motor will run faster. This is going to require a couple different blocks, so let's go ahead and grab them all first. So it's a good idea to start off with the when program starts block from the events bubble. Next we need two motor blocks. We're going to grab the set speed 2 block as well as the start motor block. Next, we can go ahead and jump into the sensors bubble, and we want to grab the force sensor input block. This detects how much force the sensor is reading right now. After this, there are two more blocks that you need. The first one is in the operators bubble, and you want to choose the multiplication operator. It's the third one from the top in this little group, and you can just drag it over here. Finally, we're going to go into the control bubble and grab the forever block and drop that down. So take a moment to think about what we're trying to do. Depending on how much force is being applied, that's how fast the motor spins or rotates. So what we need is a loop that will always be reading the sensor and updating the motor without too much lag. That's what this block is for right here. We want our loop to run forever and run fairly quickly so that it very quickly updates the speed of the motor and then runs the motor without having to start and stop every single time. For our force sensor input, rather than percent, I want to use newtons, and I'm going to drop it into the math operator block right here. Drag it over so you can see it, and I'm going to multiply it by 10, and I'll explain why we're multiplying by 10 in just a sec. I'm going to grab it and drop it down into the set speed 2. And what our code says right now is when this program starts, this loop is going to run forever. We're going to set the speed of our motor equal to whatever the force sensor is reading multiplied by 10, and then we're going to start the motor. If we didn't multiply by 10 and press down on the sensor, our motor speed would only be set to 10. And if it was at 5, then it would only run at 5% speed, which is very, very slow for this motor. But by multiplying it by 10 and making this a proportional controller, we're able to scale it up. And so whenever we're pressing down as hard as we can at 10 newtons, it's multiplied by 10, and our motor speed is the maximum, which is 100. And you can see this when we upload the code and test it out. If I just barely tap on the motor, it barely runs. But if I really hold it down, then we see it running at max speed. And you can do this with other sensors too. You can go into the sensors bubble and try out the distance sensor. You could even try out the color sensor and switch out input blocks. There's a lot of different things that you can do with simple controllers like this one. And a challenge you might want to try out is how do you use the distance sensor so that your robot slows down when it's getting closer and closer to another object. To use your force sensor in Python, first make sure that the force sensor is being imported through Spike, otherwise you won't be able to use any of the commands. I've also gone ahead and initialized motor for the motor that we're going to be using, and I've initialized the force sensor. In this case, it's in port B. If you don't happen to know how to initialize the force sensor or the motor, click over here and open up the knowledge base, and you can find the single motor and how to initialize it, or you can jump to the force sensor and just copy and paste this over here to initialize it. So what we're trying to do is create something called a proportional controller so that depending on what value our force sensor is detecting, our motor will run slower or faster. And to do that, we're going to go into the knowledge base and use the get force and newtons command. There are a couple other commands that you can use for the force sensor where you can take different measurements. We're going to focus on getting the force in newtons. And when you click into it, you'll notice that it doesn't have any parameters. And the reason is because all this command does is just reads whatever's going on at the force sensor at this moment. So if we scroll down to the example, what we want to do is copy this line here that says newtons equals doorbell, copy it, and paste it. Except that instead of doorbell, my force sensor is just called force. And then we want to drop that into a while loop that's set to true. And by setting the while loop to true, this loop will just always run until we choose to stop it. So what we have so far is this loop will run and it'll just always measure whatever's going on the force sensor, but it doesn't do anything. To get it to do something, we're going to copy one of the simpler commands in the single motors, and that's going to be the start command. If we click into that, we can copy the example from the very bottom. If we just copy this line and paste it, what we have now is that after the program detects how much force is being applied to the sensor, then it starts the motor. And we can set the speed of our motor to be equal to the newtons that are being detected, so that every time there's a change on our sensor, the motor will speed up or slow down accordingly. One issue though that you might notice is that the force sensor only goes up to 10 newtons. So if we just leave it like this, when the motor starts running, it's only gonna run at 10%. So if we want to set it up so that when we're at 10 newtons, it reaches 100%, we need to multiply by 100, excuse me, multiply by 10. So whenever the maximum force is applied, that's multiplied by 10, and now our motor speed is at 100. And when we upload and run the code, this is what we see. The harder we press down, the faster the motor spins. And if we don't press it at all, it doesn't spin at all. This multiplication by 10 is what makes this a simple proportional controller. And you can do this kind of control with different kinds of sensors too. We can go back and pick up the distance sensor. And you can read whatever the distance is so that your robot reacts too. And if you really want to challenge, what you can do is use this command get distance and adapt this simple code so that when your robot gets closer to something, it doesn't speed up, but rather it slows down so that it doesn't crash at any point. And here we have a quick comparison of the blocks versus Python coding that we used. Thank you so much for watching, and I really hope you learned something in this video. Please remember to like the video, and if you want to learn more Spike Prime concepts, make sure to check the other tutorials that we have.